show me everything.
255 here. What up? What up? Today we're looking at the lore of this character, Koma Kashima. Forgive me if I messed the brother's name up. After his lore, we're going to look at his gameplay, and then I'm going to give you a few general ideas and discussions about Melty Blood. Okay, so his lore comes from the website typemoonfandom.com/wiki/Koma Kashima. Koma was born into the Kashima family as something that shouldn't have been born. He is the eldest son of the Kashima. As a family of mixed bloods, they continued to mix with Oni while attempting to make their bloodline stronger. And the sin of their several hundred years of work finally took form in their generation. He had preserved the desired purity they had been waiting for, but even they, who were not normal, realized that he was the path to their destruction. They thought that this is where the bloodlines of all hybrids end, and that they were either just terribly slower than others or arrived there terribly early. Calling him a demon child, they desperately tried to hide away his existence. He was given a dark, traditional Japanese-styled room, and that was all the freedom he was allowed. He was a small child, so he was likely satisfied with the space. He would also often glare at the space as if it were too large, but he would have been unable to voice his complaints in the first place. He didn't understand people, their behaviors, expressions, or words, or anything else very well. He thought that he must have been a dog rather than a human, and if that wasn't the case, the severe gap must have meant he had gone crazy. He was never taught anything, and as no one talked to him in the first place, there was no need to learn words or tell others his thoughts. His eyes could pull out the inner side of people. Most of the people who met him were nothing but terrified. So that is how he learned people were like. Since they only acted like that, it was natural that there was no need to learn words. He would have rather been among the animals in the forest he liked so much, but they couldn't let the family successor, even if only in formality, move around in such a manner. It was likely an embarrassment for them to have the next head wish to live as a beast. While wild, he wasn't a fool like they believed. He matured quickly. He learned how to seal his power early during his life, and he never once opened his cage since he was born. He kept suppressing his thirst, and the beast called himself, much like a fasting that began right when he was born. It is normal that a hybrid only feels such bloodlust after growing up as human and finding something he needed protection. The inversion impulse of his bloodline destroys a person within a year, even with the mind of an adult. He understood that fact quietly, even though he was a child without words or the concept of a family. He was trying to protect his family even without knowing, even without understanding how such things as a father, mother, or siblings are related to him. He still suppressed himself to protect them, likely because he knew that returning to soil peacefully someday after being forgotten was the right thing. It didn't last long, and the one who put an end to it was someone other than him. Receiving the curse, you were out of your mind since you were born. He was shot in the head with a bullet. The words were true, as he was different since he was born, which is why he was able to suppress the blood longer and didn't go crazy like them. The boy who had been out of his mind since he was born was unable to even die from such a thing as a bullet. After the mansion burnt down and the clan was slaughtered, only he was left. However, because the Kashima family itself has already died out, he is treated as the family head. It was easy for him to end something like a family because he was unable to understand it in the first place. He possessed no regret, emotion, remorse, or feelings. And he was a living being who could only exist that way from the beginning. The head of the Saki family arrived afterward, and they eventually took him into their mansion. Barely 10 years old, he was chained by both his arms and legs while being covered in wounds. He encountered Kiri Nana during his slaughter of the Saki family, and he had his eye crushed due to Kiri's unconscious idea that it would let him defeat Koma later in life. His head simply dropped down without a scream, and Kiri left the room while the dripping blood stained the floor. And there's more to his lore, but we'll stop there. I mean, what such an involved character. Such an involved character. And when you look at his fighting style, it's built the same way. When you listen to the character, the way he fights, as we look at the trailer, you're going to see it in me in that way. He reminds me a lot of Goki from Street Fighter, like the stomping on the ground. And I love his walk. When he walks backwards. You'll notice that. And this character is an excellent example of how characters sell fighting games. Most of the characters in Melty Blood don't even appeal to me. But in a single player fighting game, you're really only going to be trying to master or largely trying to learn most of the moves of one character. You might learn a second to have a backup, maybe a third, depending on your time period. But depending on how casual or serious you are about fighting games, you're probably picking just one character that you really like, especially with a game like Melty Blood, where it does seem like it's definitely a more advanced fighting game, and they're not trying to hide that or sell this as a beginning point. And I'm happy about that. Let's check out this trailer. That's Arc System, normal clashing system, whatever it hits. This game does have an interesting, I guess, parry system as well. I love the fact that they gave this character so many grab moves. I can't wait to see how plus he is on stuff. So they gave you a lot, but they didn't. You can see mostly his normal, that's fine. It looks like his level one's easier to combo off of, at least from normals. That looked like a rising kick that launched him into the air. That was pretty on point. So some of those are actually parries. Yeah, this is definitely a game for beginners. They're gonna try to sell it like that. I'm really excited for this game. And Melty Blood, if you got a character you love in it, I think you're gonna greatly enjoy it as well. But definitely you're gonna be in for some advanced play. And with anime fighters, people really put the time in to learn to play the game. And as you can tell, when you're playing, it looks like you're playing a damn anime. So this is DeepMind 255 out. 1.